Welcome back to St. Paul's, where the cathedral is now filling up, and we are within half an hour of this national service of Thanksgiving. The Prime Minister has just arrived, and we've just seen the Duke of Kent and the Duke of Gloucester, and some more royal guests arriving now. Robert Hardman is still with me.
This is Prince and Princess Michael of Kent, being shown by and the Duke of Kent ahead of them, followed by other members of the family. About to take their place near the front in the main seats. We've seen the sort of the cousins and the wider royal family. We've been here for some time now, but now we're getting into more familiar royal territory, if you like.
They're all being greeted at the Great West Door by the Dean and Chapter of St. Paul's Cathedral, the Dean, Dr. David Ison, and the Chapter. They are the canons with the Dean, are the governing body, if you like, of the cathedral. They're part of the welcoming party, and Duke of Kent now being welcomed by the Dean and Chapter, and then by the Bishop of London, Richard Charters, and by the Archbishop of Canterbury. That's the formal process of welcome. Gloucester there. If we take a look at the other end of the cathedral where people are taking their seats, because we have a big contingent now of politicians who've gathered. There's an interesting little chat going on between Jeremy Corbyn, the Labour leader, who is very proudly a dedicated Republican. He's here nonetheless, part of this National Service of Thanksgiving, chatting there to Mr. Speaker John Bercow, who of course in days gone by was a Conservative Member of Parliament, but they're having a very friendly chat about what's going on. Let's have a look at some of the other politicians who've gathered as well, because they represent all parts of the United Kingdom. Carwyn Jones, the First Minister of Wales. And then next to him, that is Peter Morrell, who is the husband of Nicola Sturgeon, who was very busy last night taking part in a pretty feisty debate on the referendum on ITV, a debate on the referendum campaign. We also have Arlene Foster here, who is the First Minister of Northern Ireland, just there on the left. And just behind we have Ken McIntosh, who is the newly elected presiding officer of the Scottish Parliament. So he's here with in a Scottish party with Nicola Sturgeon and others. The Prime Minister is also in his place now. David Cameron, who will be giving one of the readings in this service. Samantha Cameron, and there we have George Osborne too. All of them, of course, it goes without saying, having mentioned Nicola Sturgeon's activities, all of them immersed in this pretty hard-fought referendum campaign. But today, all thoughts away from that. All thoughts focusing very sharply on the business here, which is to give thanks for the Queen's 90 years.
That's right. It's not a day for dwelling on any sort of splits at all. It's we've got Remainers and Brexiters and left and right here. A very substantial political turnout. I mean, this is one of the most extensive numbers of cabinet ministers and representatives of all parts of all the legislatures in the country, devolved assemblies. To here we see the Duke of Kent coming down the nave to take the seat, followed by his son, the Earl of St Andrews. Prince Michael of Kent a little to the rear of them, and there is Prince and Princess Michael of Kent with their children, Freddie and Lady Gabriella.
When did we last see a presence of the royal family on this scale?
Well, I think you'd have to go back to something like the royal wedding to see quite so many members of the family. I mean, the as well as those in the line of succession, there's a very extensive selection of cousins, if you like. They've got representatives from the Bowes Lyon family, the Queen's family on her mother's side. There are many members of the Mountbatten family here. There's also a lot of members of the royal household here, because obviously, you know, for them, this is an extremely important day too. This because the Queen's official birthday is tomorrow, but her real birthday was back in April. They've, if you like, been living this birthday rather like Her Majesty for many weeks now, and they're very keen to be here today too.
Let's have a look at the latest arrivals outside the cathedral.